Now we'll multiply binomials that contain radicals. And just to review, to multiply radicals, the index must be the same, and then we multiply the coefficients together, and then we multiply the radicands together. And then we simplify the product if possible. And to multiply two binomials, we'll have four products. Sometimes this is called foiling, but I prefer to think of this as double distribution. We need to distribute square root 3 into the second binomial here and here, and then distribute negative 5 into the second binomial here and here. So our first product will be square root 3 times square root 3, which is going to be equal to the square root of 3 times 3. And then we're going to have square root 3 times 7. Notice how the 7 is not underneath the square root, so this will be plus 7 square root 3. And then we're going to have negative 5 times square root 3, that'll be minus 5 square root 3. And then we have negative 5 times positive 7, that's negative 35, or minus 35. And now we need to simplify the square roots if possible, and combine like terms. Well, 3 squared is a perfect square, that's equal to 9. So this simplifies to 3. Next, these two are like radicals because they both contain a factor of square root 3. So to combine these, we'll subtract the coefficients. Since 7 minus 5 is 2, this simplifies to plus 2 square root 3. And we still have minus 35. So now we have two more like terms. 3 minus 35 is equal to negative 32. So finally we have negative 32 plus 2 square root 3. And now for the second example, again we're going to have four products. We'll distribute 3 square root 2 here and here, and then we'll distribute square root 5 here and here. So the first product is 3 square root 2 times square root 2. That's going to be 3 times the square root of 2 times 2. And then we're going to have 3 square root 2 times negative 2 square root 5. We'll first multiply 3 and negative 2, that's negative 6. And then we'll have square root 2 times 5. Next we have square root 5 times square root 2. That's plus square root 5 times 2. And then for our last product we have square root 5 times negative 2 square root 5. That'll be minus 2 times the square root of 5 times 5. Let's see what simplifies. Here's a perfect square. This will simplify to 2, so we'll have 3 times 2. Then we have minus 6. This does not simplify, so it's minus 6 square root 10. This doesn't simplify either. This is plus square root 10. Here's a perfect square factor. So we have minus 2 times 5. Let's continue simplifying. This is going to be 6. Now these two are like terms. This has a coefficient of 1. And since negative 6 plus 1 is negative 5, this simplifies to negative 5 square root 10, or minus 5 square root 10. And then here we have minus 10. And since 6 minus 10 is negative 4, we finally have negative 4 minus 5 square roots of 10. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.